It's Madden NFL 22, and today's clash of conferences is just moments away. It's the boys and the Chiefs, and it comes your way next.
From one of the loudest venues in the NFL, there's a look at Arrowhead Stadium here in Kansas City. A few short moments ago, these two teams made their way out of the stadium tunnels, and the noise level in this place was just about off the charts. They are set for football as the Chiefs get set to do battle with the Dallas Cowboys. Brandon Gaughan alongside Charles Davis. CD, you look at the Cowboys in this matchup. Their offense is one that doesn't rely too heavily on just one guy. They like to spread things around as best they can.
You're right about that. It's a diverse unit, and they like to run their offense by what they call game plan, meaning each and every week they study the opponent, they probe its weaknesses, and they move the ball around that way. They emphasize who's going to get it based on what they think they'll accomplish in that game. Other teams, they're a system team. They're going to run what they run no matter what. I like this style of offense. It suits them well.
Here's the kicker, Harrison Butker, ready to get this one started. And we are underway from Kansas City. This fielded right at the goal line. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line.
Let's go!
The Dallas Cowboys and Dak Prescott set to go on offense for the first time. And with Dak at the controls, his sixth season under center now as the Cowboys quarterback.
You remember last year he got off to an incredible start, threw for over 450 yards in three straight weeks, including 502 against the Cleveland Browns in week four, just 4 yards short of the franchise's single-game record. Then came his injury in week five that pretty well derailed the Cowboys' season.
Prescott looks to throw on first. Man open, that's complete to Dalton Schultz. The game's first play produces 6 yards, brings up second down.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two, wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. Working with a second and four. Elliott a first down and more. And he'll get this all the way down to the Chiefs 24. 49 yards on the ground for him so far. Ezekiel Elliott, a guy who considers himself underrated, has told his detractors to put some respect on his name. Hard not to respect a run like that.
And that's why he's one of the best running backs in the game today, because this run combined all the elements. Started with patience, and he was just waiting for the right lane to materialize. Then once he saw it, he used his speed and escapability in tandem and turned this into a tremendous play.
Elliott. And a good run as he manages 7 yards down to the 17. The impressive opening drive continues and just space being created by those guys up front.
We're seeing this the same way, aren't we? We are seeing an offensive line. As this game gets started, as it starts to unfold, that they are dominating the line of scrimmage.
On second down, Elliott. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
They did tell us they wanted to establish the ground game early, didn't they?
They did, and a small sample size that we've seen so far, but pretty good return.
Yeah, you gotta like that. They've strung together a couple of first downs, established what they wanted, the running game. And guess what? They also got their lead guy running it pretty well, too.
A first down carry by Elliott. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. The 4-3 defense there did its job, funneled things right to the middle linebacker.
If they do a nice job of playing team defense, everyone takes care of their responsibilities, that allows that guy in the middle to do his job, which is search and destroy.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. They'll try to throw now. Prescott over the middle, hauled in by Lamb. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. We'll step aside and get an update when we return to Arrowhead. Take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. Well, that's how they envisioned it, get the football to start the game and score it.
And I don't know if that was scripted, was it an audible, or was it just a play call that they had in their pocket. No matter what, they had the right call on against the right defense, and they end up in the end zone.
Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. And this is up and good to make it 7-0 Cowboys. So that drive, 7 plays in length, and it's capped off with a Cowboys touchdown. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. Patrick Mahomes now in his 5th season with the Chiefs, ready to bring out this high-powered Kansas City offense for the first time.
Another big year from arguably the best quarterback in the NFL. And while we enjoy his excellence, let's not take it for granted. He threw for over 4,700 yards, second only to Deshaun Watson, 38 touchdown passes, and led the Chiefs back to the Super Bowl while completing a career-high 66% of his passes. He did have a toe injury during the playoffs that hobbled him, and he had off-season surgery to correct that. We expect this guy to continue to be magnificent.
Throwing on first down is Mahomes. This one complete to Mecole Hardman. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. The drive starting play, a good one. Give him 19.
Defense gives up a touchdown on the opening drive. Offense, you got to want to get out there and get those points back right now.
And that's a sharp throw there to get this drive off to a good start. Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. Throwing now is Mahomes. And this one caught by Travis Kelce. And he takes this down deep on the Cowboys' side of the field. And when we talk about yards after the catch, you think about speedy little receivers, but Travis Kelce was 3rd in the NFL in 2020 in that category.
Yeah, and that was sheer determination right there. He decided before the play, if there was a sliver,
He was going to take advantage of it. Looked the ball in, turned on the jets, and took it all the way.
And you can see the distance traveled there after the catch on the Next Gen Stats.
So now following the big play, they've got a first and goal all the way down at the 10. And a short pickup there down to about the 9. Give them maybe a yard, quite the opposite from the previous big gainer.
Early down stuff's to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
Here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And from the 9, they get this to the 5-yard line.
I'm wondering if the same thing went through your mind as mine. When I see a big man like that make a catch, all I keep thinking to myself is, big man with football. Look out, everyone. He may not juke you a whole lot, right? He may not run past you because of his size. You talk about a guy weighing in the 270 range. But boy, once he gets his mitts on the ball.
And that's caught. It's Kelce. Touchdown, Kansas City. A 5-yard touchdown catch. And the Chiefs are an extra point away from tying up this football game. And the QB rating right now, sky high. 4 for 4 on that opening drive, and it ends with a touchdown pass.
Yeah, I don't know quite how to figure it out. I think I need my friends from MIT to come in and help me. I think 158.3 is the number one.
Yep, that's the
right?
High
that's mark. The highest you can get. That's where he is. He'd like to continue on that pace.
Harrison Butker is on for the extra point. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7. So that drive spanned 5 plays, and it's capped off with a Kansas City touchdown. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. This is Tony Pollard. And he'll be stopped up at the 25.
Come on, fellas.
Second drive forthcoming here for the Dallas Cowboys.
And that last drive, it was all about the ground game. Ground and pound.
And I don't care how we're playing the game these days. Offensive linemen still want to fire out and smack the guy opposite them and move the football on the ground. They feel better about that. That's what they want to do. That's how they want to play, and that's how they got it done.
Yeah, they got it for a touchdown last drive. Let's see what happens here. So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a 1st and 10 at their 25-yard line. Here's Prescott. They'll set up the screen to Elliott. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger game. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
And this is going to be a Cowboys first down as the tackle made it about the 43-yard line.
That type of run right there, that just fires me up when I watch it because that's maybe the most underrated aspect of his game. The ability to break tackles and know where the first down chains are and pick them up.
He's tough, good pedigree. Dad Stacy was a linebacker at Missouri.
And how about mom on the track team? So I think that's where the speed came from. And she's not shy about letting us know that too.
Yeah, he got the best of both worlds. They keep on the ground with Elliott. And able to work about 5 yards out of this as he's taken down up near the 47.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
From the 47, it's 2nd and 5. Prescott from the gun. Flush to his right. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down.
Well, that was man coverage. So once he decides to run with the football, there's no one to account for him, and he turns it into a nice gain.
These two teams all tied after one. Start of the second quarter, and it's the Cowboys in possession as they've got it with a first and 10. They'll run on first down. It's Elliott. And some room to maneuver. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. 87 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here in this first half. We've seen him break off a big run already in this game, and for a second, that one looked like it might be another.
Yeah, I think that any defense would say, look, we can't let him get to the second level, because sometimes he'll break off the big run on his own, but oftentimes you get additional blocking at the second level, which gets you deeper into the secondary.
Play action, Prescott. This will be caught inside the 10. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago, because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Now Elliott. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Cowboy touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott, an 8-yard touchdown run. And the Cowboys have taken the lead. People always talk about one of his biggest strengths running the football, vision, and he found the spot there, went into the end zone.
You're exactly right about that, and it wasn't just the vision, right? Once he saw the gap, decisiveness, made up his mind, and about the power to finish the play. Not only did he get good blocking, he created his own space as well.
Zuerlein connects on the extra point, and that makes the score 14-7. So the drive winds up going 75 yards in 7 plays. And it culminates in a touchdown run by Ezekiel Elliott. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. Taking it about the 1. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. Out comes Patrick Mahomes in the Chiefs offense. And he had the touchdown on the last drive, also 4 for 4. Very, very effective. What does he need to do to translate that forward into this drive?
Not think that what he saw in coverages last time is exactly what he's going to get again. He's got to play ahead and start thinking to himself, okay, we just did that. What are they going to take away now? What do we go to as a counter, and continue to encourage his offensive line to continue to give him time?
They were really good on the last drive. On first and 10, here's Mahomes. Taking a deep shot here for Hardman. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. A big pickup of 38. Every defensive staff harps on limiting explosive plays. Job not so well done there.
Yeah, they talk about it all the time. A lot harder to stop, though, isn't it? And when you think of an explosive play, most offensive staffs define them as passes of 20 or more yards and runs of 15 or more yards.
They went zooming past that number there.
So the big play moves him all the way across midfield to the 40 now for first and 10.
Looking to throw is Mahomes. That would almost intercepted, but it's incomplete. Not a good throw there, and it'll be second down.
Well, he did almost everything right. Excellent coverage, breaks on the football, just unable to haul it in and take it the other way. So he dropped an interception. The key for him now, don't dwell on it. Just move on to the next play.
So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. Now the Georgia Southern man. This is Jerick McKinnon. And little room to maneuver there. He gets it down to about the 39. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves him with third and 9 looming.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
This one swung out to Williams. And they'll get him down at the 34, and he's going to be short of the first by a few yards. He did his best to just get four out of that, but not enough. And now fourth down.
We can make this one pretty simple. Locked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back. But how about the way they ran to the football and knocked him down to force a fourth down?
Butker's kick here is good, and they'll cut the lead back down to four now at 14-10. So the 3 points there, and CD, that helps them inch a bit closer.
Yeah, partner, when you're losing, any points you see go on the board in your favor, you're happy to take them.
After the field goal, here's Butker to kick it away. On the return, Tony Pollard from his end zone. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further. Zeke and the Cowboys ready to begin their next drive. He's in a zone, second quarter, already closing in on a 100-yard game.
And that's the magic number for a running back. Anytime you get to that triple digits, that's all you're looking for. But he's got a chance to really exceed that in this one.
Yeah, he does. That's been the gold standard for a long time, hasn't it, that 100-yard mark?
It really has, and that never has to shift because it's in a game. It's a 1,000-yard mark. I'm wondering, since we've gone from 12 to 14 to 16 games, maybe we need to up that a little.
And he goes down. It's a sack. They get him back at his own 3-yard line. It was Frank Clark that time who got in there to bring him down.
Well, if an offense is going to throw the ball in this part of the field, any pass rusher will tell you that's his favorite part. Gets a chance to get after the quarterback. It's almost like a reverse red zone. They can create points using their defense, and this time they take their man down.
Well, they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. Back near his goal line, it's Prescott. And he'll hit the slant route. That's caught by Cooper. That catch good for 5. It's third down.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw.
That is caught by Lamb. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Well, they were backed up to start the drive, but how about that aggressiveness? Firing it downfield right away. Nice job there getting out towards what would have been their normal starting position.
First down, it's Elliott,
and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Play fake. Here's Prescott. Dancing to his left, and he'll slide to a halt here, still a little shy of the first down marker. He'll end up getting five out of that, but now they're looking at third down. And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action. But business to take care of before we get there.
A two-minute drill before the coaches' two-minute drill.
And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Normally on third down and short yardage, you're thinking to throw to your tight end. It's just going to be a simple chain mover. But this time they let him roam down the field, and a nice dart picks up the first down and then some.
Now Prescott, his throw incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Prescott now from the 50. That one complete, Elliott. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
He's had success running the football, and this is more or less an extension of that because they drop it off to him on the screen. And I'll bet he's thinking to himself, if I didn't have to slow up a bit here in traffic, I could have really made something out of that one.
This will be play number eight here on the drive. It's third and a yard. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. This will be play number eight here on the drive. It's third and a yard. And again, it's Prescott. And this pass broken up. But the contact well timed there. And now fourth down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
Feeling like they're not quite in field goal range yet, they're going to go for it on fourth. Running with Elliott. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Now Prescott.
letting one fly deep for Cooper. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. Actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over. Then they get a chance to continue their drive.
Line of scrimmage, again the 37 as they line up second and 10. Throwing, Prescott. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And this one, incomplete. Oh, he couldn't hang on to it. In the end zone, and that's one that'll haunt you. And now it brings up third down. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have him looking at third and 10. Prescott down. He's got a man complete. It's Amari Cooper. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
They'll throw again. Prescott. That's into a crowd and intercepted. Picked off by Legarius Sneed. And the Chiefs are going to get this back to their own 34-yard line.
Well, this had trouble written all over from the start. He's got two extra defensive backs in the game he's got to deal with. They're in a dime set. So everywhere he's looking, he's seeing a different color jersey. And sure enough, this one winds up being intercepted.
KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And with Mahomes under center, anything's possible. Watch out for the deep ball. He's going to throw one up for the end zone. And that is incomplete.
So we have reached halftime here with the visiting Cowboys out on top.
As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
Okay, right, Brandon. Thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to this slimmed-down version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. First, though, let's get a check on the next-gen stats from that first half for the Cowboys. And even though they've got a halftime lead, they're likely devising ways as we speak to try and get a little more production from their passing game. Meanwhile, for the Chiefs, they too found some success throwing the football. But I think both teams would say there's room for improvement in the second half.
All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point.
It'll be the Chiefs football to begin quarter number three, and they trail here as we are back underway now on EA Sports. This will be fielded inside the five. Well, now how about this return? And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return.
Here comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to begin quarter number three. And they're still very much in this game, although they do trail. What's the game plan, Charles, for the second half?
It might be a little counterintuitive because most people will think losing equals passing the ball more, but I'd establish the running game. They kind of went away from it in the first half. I think if they get back in balance, it'll help them when they put the ball back in the air.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at the 31-yard line. And the first play of the drive goes to McKinnon. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Working from the gun, Mahomes. Incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield. Let's get the call. Orlando Brown, the former Raven, the guilty party.
Still second down.
Now they face a second and long following the holding penalty. Now here's Mahomes. To the right side, it's Kelce. And he'll be upended after a gain of five, up to the 25-yard line.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
And on third down, the Cowboys bringing an extra defensive back. Now Mahomes. Screen play, McKinnon. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. Fourth down now after a loss of two.
The whole idea of the screen pass is to fool the defense in a big way and create a big play.
They weren't fooled.
Not one second, not one bit. How about them figuring it out, diagnosing it, and spilling it for lost yardage?
Here's the Chiefs punter now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. He'll send this one into the Midwestern air, and it's a good one. On the return is Lamb. An 8-yard return there after a punt of 47. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate, and of course they'd like to forget the inning, the interception, but they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know what, a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And incomplete on the deep ball.
Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield. But that's okay because the second part of that is if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit and they may have to change accordingly.
Here's second and 10 now from the 35. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. And that falls to the ground, incomplete. Boy, nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up third down.
This has certainly been a physical game so far. Limited scoring opportunities for both sides, and there's another chance that goes unfulfilled.
An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
Third down, it's Prescott. Open man, Lamb, it's complete. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Whenever we talk about moving the sticks and controlling the football, there's a great example right there. Those are the third downs you need to convert to win football games. We're in the third quarter of this one, and this is a tight one. In order to maintain pace, keep the ball away from the other team, and put points on the board, those are the plays they need to continue to convert.
They'll run on first down. Elliott. And he'll take it across the 50 and into Chief territory. 109 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball, but when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and two. Off play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott. He finds his target. It's Schultz. And he's going to be out of bounds down around the 35-yard line. Give him 10 there. Good enough for a Cowboy first down.
Second and short. That's a rundown, so it's definitely a good time to go play action if you're feeling it. And they do so and pick up a first down.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Prescott to throw it. He finds his man complete. That's Schultz. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
The completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught and you don't give up much run after the catch.
On second down, it's Elliott, and he'll be brought down at about the 25 after a pickup of 4. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
They go to Elliott again. And Elliott trying to work his way forward, but it looks like he did not make it. They'll be marked inches short. No gain on the play, and that's going to lead him to fourth down.
I apologize in advance, partner, but the beefeaters on the interior of this D-line, you just know they were licking their chops on third and short. And yes, they were rewarded with a tasty dish, stuffing that one short of a first down.
The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on fourth and inches. They'll run it with Elliott. And down he goes, but the stiff arm utilized effectively there, and it helps him move the sticks. They only needed a few inches, and they didn't get much more than that, but by about the width of a shoelace, they convert on fourth down. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Here's Prescott. He's got his man. It's Gallup. Touchdown, Cowboys! Michael Gallup on the receiving end from Dak Prescott. And the Cowboys, they push out in front further. Circle that drive, because that might be one to remember. Well executed to give them a little cushion.
Well, let's take it into the boxing ring. You talk about them commanding it, keeping the fight where they wanted to, whether it was in the center of the ring or putting them on the ropes, because it was jab, jab, jab. And finally, the haymaker to put that drive away.
Now Zuerlein on to add the extra point. It's good, and it's 21-10. A 10-play drive that time, and it culminates in a Dallas touchdown. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. Taken in at the 3. And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. KC's offense ready to take over. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 21. On play action, it's Mahomes. That one caught by Tyreek Hill. And all the way in for the Kansas City touchdown.
I think you can make a fair case for Tyreek Hill being the most explosive player in the NFL when he gets his hands on the football, and that was Exhibit A.
Well, in this league where coordinators worry so much about drawing up the right routes, blocking assignments, misdirections and stuff, they have these precise arrows and movements. Sometimes the best plays just come from the schoolyard where you look at your fastest guy and say, go long, go get it, big man.
Mahomes will throw for it, and he's got it. So the try for two successful, and with it, they're back within a field goal. I guess the coach looked at the two-point cheat sheet, said go for it, get it to a three-point game, and they did it.
Yeah, and sometimes you just throw out time of game. You don't worry about that. There's just a feel sometimes in making that call, and he felt good about what he had for a two-point conversion, and now they're only down three and feeling great about themselves.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Pollard elects to keep it, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. And let's gaze our attention on Ezekiel Elliott. And there are the numbers. Got off to that torrid hot start. We thought he was in for maybe a career day. Not the case.
No doubt about it. It almost looks like a misprint after what we saw in the first half. But let's give a little bit of credit to the guys on our side of the ball. They went in at halftime, made a few adjustments. And you know what else? They didn't lose their confidence in how their ability to play. Because a lot of times you get beat down in the first half, it gets ugly in the second half. They've come out with a new resolve and a renewed determination.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Well, that was one of the few times they've been able to contain him thus far. He's over 100 yards for the game, but he lost a bit off his total on that carry.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. They play fake to Elliott. Now Prescott. And the Chiefs are going to get him. Frank Clark picks up his second sack of the afternoon.
So that time, Charles, a quarterback helpless really in the pocket in the face of a pass rush like that. They were on him instantly.
Yeah, that's one where you turn to your lineman and say, guys, can I get a little help here? And you have to ask politely, because remember, they're blocking for you the entire game. But as a quarterback, you've also got to have the clock running in your head when you need to get rid of the football. But this time, he had no chance. They were on him instantly.
Throwing the out route, incomplete. That's Schultz. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down.
Let's just make this one simple. Could he be any more open than he was on that play?
Yeah, they lost him going to the outside.
Hard to believe, because you go through your accounting on each and every defensive snap. Who's got who? What defense you're in? That was totally a blown coverage.
Anger is on to punt, and he gets this one away. Here's Hardman to return. It's a 42-yard punt, but 8 on the return. And it's Chiefs football, first and 10. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, we'll see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last
time.
That's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
We're back now in KC. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. On first down, Mahomes. They complete it to Hill. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. First down for the Chiefs. Solid chunk of yardage, 17 on the play.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Mahomes going to throw. That's out to Hill, right side complete. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Operating from the red zone now, Mahomes. A dump down to McKinnon. And able to get this down inside the 15, either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
Little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete. I guess they're in a situation now, fourth quarter, where they're forced to take some chances, but I don't know that that was the type of a chance you want to take.
And that one could very easily have been intercepted. And if it does get picked off, that could possibly seal this one.
The Chiefs on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. Now it's Mahomes again. Buying time to his left. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the 1. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down. So there you go. Save your best scramble of the day for a big-time situation in the fourth quarter, picking up the first.
You don't want to use it up early, right? You want to make sure you save it for that exact moment, that key time. And that's what he did, although you and I both know it wasn't planned that way. But what a nice job using his eyes, scanning the field, and realizing when it was time to exit the pocket and go.
Throwing now is Mahomes. This is caught by Hill for a Chiefs touchdown. Tyreek Hill, his second touchdown of the afternoon, and the Chiefs are going to jump back in front. There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
Butker on for the PAT. And that will make this a 4-point game. So this drive spans 7 plays, and it winds up with the Chiefs hitting pay dirt. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Now Pollard. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. Let's go! The Dallas offense back out onto the field. Now the bad news for them, they've seen that cushion they once had totally evaporate, and they're working from behind. The good news, they now have the opportunity to regain the lead right back.
Good job over there, baby. I see y'all. Good job over there, baby.
So Prescott of the Cowboys now with a 1st and 10 at their own 17-yard line. Here's Prescott. Over the middle, hauled in by Lamb. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. First play of the drive going for 14 and also going for a first down. Cool under pressure right there, escaping the pocket and finding what I think was not his primary target.
And some of these guys are just so comfortable getting outside of the pocket that they'll do it on purpose. There doesn't even need to be a breakdown. They move, and they know it affects the defense because a lot of times you get lost in coverage in the secondary, and I think you're exactly right. Wasn't his primary target. Found a secondary guy who sprang open, probably because of his movement out of the pocket.
They go back to Elliott. He's been busy. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. 120 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
Saw through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. Prescott off play action. On the crossing route, he hits his man, Amari Cooper. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. A good-looking drive for the Cowboys so far. It's a first down.
And, partner, they're locked in man coverage out left and they end up running a crossing route. Rounded it a little bit more than a slant. And he's just going to angle himself towards the right side of the field, and that's very difficult for a defender to shadow him across all that ground.
Prescott on first down. And his throw here is incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
They work again from the 38 on second and 10. Prescott from the gun. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And a high throw there as this is knocked away, down to the ground and incomplete.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually that becomes man on man. And you've got to trust yourself and go up in that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. Now the red challenge flag makes an appearance as Andy Reid wants a second opinion. Did he keep those feet in bounds? That's the question they've got to decide. And I got to say, watching it in real time, it was awfully close.
Yeah, certainly looked like a heck of a catch because he didn't appear to bobble it, which could complicate things. But even with the benefit of replay, that's pretty tight.
Well, here's the call.
Let's go, boys. Bring it up.
After review of the play.
So the challenge there does not go their way. This will indeed remain a completed pass. First down, Prescott. To the right side, he's got Cooper. It's complete. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
Throwing again on second down. Prescott firing quickly here, and that's complete. They'll get just a couple, but the sticks move again.
They got a completion there, but that's clearly an example of one side happy, the other side not very happy. Defense, very, hey, take 1 or 2 yards. We're good with that. Offense, you got to expect to get more on the passing play.
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game.
Here we go, deep.
So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. And he can't quite get there. Tackled down at the one. A solid pickup of 12 yards, and now they're knocking on the door.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. The Mississippi State man, Chris Jones, with a sack there. So they get pushed back to the 11, and here's second and goal. Now Prescott. That's into the hands of Gallup over the middle. And this carry, despite the good move, will be stopped short of the 10. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards.
Get him, boys! Get him, boys!
A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. Now Dak. And that is incomplete. So this defense, they looked a little shaky to start the drive. The bottom line, they're a play away from finishing it off.
They rocked them a little bit on this drive, didn't they? But as you and I both know, it's not how you start, it's how you finish. They have a chance to end it right here.
Likely the play of the game here, trailing in the final quarter and going for it on fourth and goal. Desperation time, Prescott on fourth. He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the fourth.
Wow, wow, wow. I know it's a never-say-never situation, but to me, that looks like that's the one that's going to finish them off.
The score that puts them in front here late, but now you got to rally your kick team, don't you, and say the last thing we need is a big return.
And what happens is guys get overeager, get out of their lane because they're so excited they want to make the last tackle. You mess up, could come back at you a long way.
Now an important extra point here to stretch this lead to a field goal. He's got it, and this is indeed up to a three-point lead. So that one, a 13-play drive in total, and it's capped off with a Cowboys touchdown. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. Patrick Mahomes in the offense. Down by a field goal, 46 seconds to go. They need at minimum 3 points out of this as they come up first and 10. Mahomes will throw, finding Kelce, and he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out, and by a few inches, that'll be a first down. Now another timeout called for by the offense. as they'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game. Mahomes to throw it. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down.
Well, their first sack of the game, and it doesn't come from a usual suspect, not somebody up front, but Charles, a defensive back getting in there.
And I can tell you from experience, he's beyond excited to make that play because you're exactly right. Isn't normal to call his number to run at the quarterback like that. Usually you're defending the pass, but he takes full advantage and dumps him to the turf.
A hole to dig out of here, second and 17. Mahomes. Complete, the tight end Kelsey. The reception good for seven. It's third down. Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play where still you're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot. We'll be right back.